So, the other day, Gigabyte sent over this behemoth RX 6950XT. And as you can see, it has a magnificently ginormous cooler on it, and this graphics card has been driving me crazy since the moment I first took it out of the box. So what we're gonna do in today's video is I'm gonna walk you through the problem, and then how I tried to diagnose it, and then we're gonna talk about Gigabyte's response to the whole situation. My initial plan for this video was to take the RX 6950XT and the RTX 3090 Ti, throwing them in an arena, dropping a knife on the floor and just kinda seeing what happened. But then, when the 6950XT handily got its cheeks clapped at 1440p, I was confused. That's not supposed to happen, right? Especially with a game like Battlefield 5, which really likes it some AMD GPU. So I went and had a look at some reviews and realized that, yeah, my 6950XT shouldn't have been so easily handled by the 3090 Ti. And then, after doing some digging, the only metrics of how my card was running that didn't make sense, aside from the, quite frankly, crazy coil whine from the card, was the power draw figures. You can see here in this tech power-up review with their Sapphire cards, they were getting about 390 watts of power draw while gaming, where I was seeing 290 watts. In fact, that 290 watts was lower than what tech power-up saw their 6900 XT drawing. Now you may be thinking, Dawid, clearly the Sapphire card just has a particularly aggressive power draw, but Tech PowerUp also reviewed the Gigabyte version of the 6950XT, and their Gigabyte card was drawing 390 watts. The same goes for the review the tech testers did on their Gigabyte card. More on that later, actually, but there's clearly something weird going on with my card. Interestingly, Digital Trends also got a Gigabyte 6950XT, and they were reporting the same max power draw of 290 watts that I was seeing on my card, and they were also having weirdly low performance, so it seems like my Gigabyte card isn't the only one suffering from malnutrition. So having had a brief look at the problem, let's check in with past Dawid to see how he tried to fix the problem. Now, I've tried a couple of things with this graphics card so far. I've tried three different driver versions, DDU wiping in between installs. That didn't have an effect. I also tried switching between the different BIOSes on the graphics card. Both the BIOSes actually behave exactly the same, which is pretty weird. I've even reinstalled the firmware on the graphics card using Gigabyte's firmware installer. That didn't help either. I also played around with pretty much every power setting I could find in the drivers, and nothing's really helped. In fact, when I go to MSI Afterburner and pull the power draw slider all the way to the right, I just get like 300 watts of power draw on the graphics card. So even overclocking it, quote unquote, hasn't really done anything. Now, one thing that does concern me about what's going on here is there's pretty bad coil whine on this graphics card, worse than the 3090 Ti had. It's so bad, in fact, that the power supply is screaming like a cat with its tail caught in the door. So the next thing that I'm gonna try and do is replace the power supply. I don't think that's gonna help with the power draw issues, but let's see what it does for the coil whine. Well, that didn't make a difference. Even with a new power supply, it still sounds like a Geiger counter near the elephant's foot. And it's not really helped our power draw figures. Not that I thought it would. But it's really weird because the backplate gets scorching hot, but if you check all of the temperatures, they all seem normal, and it's not like it's behaving like it's throttling, right? It goes straight to 290 watts and then it just sits there. So I don't know, I think I'm gonna have to get a different BIOS for this card, otherwise we're stuck. Good news! I found a video by an awesome tech channel called Tech Testers, where they also look at one of these Gigabyte RX 6950 XT cards. Although theirs was behaving a lot more in line with what you'd expect. They were getting about 380 watts of power draw as opposed to the 280 of mine. So I reached out to Tech Testers and I was like, please, can you send me the BIOS on your card so that I can flash it on here and see what it does? And they very kindly did send it. I have it here. So thank you very much, Tech Testers. masters. I'll have that video linked in the description below, so if you want to go check it out, it's down in the description. So yeah, let's install this BIOS on here and see what it does. Oh yes, success. And interestingly, you can see that there are actually different BIOS versions. So let's see if this makes a difference.
A few moments later.
Wait, why would that not have fixed it? That's so weird. I have no idea what's wrong with this graphics card. Let me try another BIOS. Let me try again. No, that also didn't help. I am very quickly running out of ideas here, to be honest. I think the only thing that I haven't tried yet is let's change the testbed out. Let's put a different system in there. See, maybe that does something. Okay, well, it's just launched in a completely different platform. Let's see what that does. And then my final idea was to just tear the graphics card down to see if there were any obvious problems on the PCB, but considering that there wasn't any throttling going on, I wasn't really hopeful. And aside from the fact that the vapor chamber just looked like a forensic team's wet dream with all of those fingerprints, it just looks like a really badass graphics card's PCB, and with my untrained eye, it looks fine. And after spending 4 days on this, I couldn't really think of anything else to do. So with that, I think it's time to quickly discuss what Gigabyte had to say about this whole situation. Now, the final thing we need to talk about here is Gigabyte's response to this whole situation. Now, I reached out to Gigabyte the moment I identified there was something wrong in my eyes with the graphics card, and then my contact at Gigabyte immediately responded with, "Well, that does seem pretty weird. I've reached out to HQ. In the meantime, have you tried both the silent and the OC BIOSes, and which firmware version do you have on the graphics card?" They then got back to me a bit later and they said, "I just had a call with HQ and they just want to know which driver version you were using for the testing." And like I mentioned earlier in the video, over the course of the testing, I used 3 different driver versions, all of which behaved roughly the same. At which point, my correspondent, who again has been very helpful through this whole process, they kept responding to all of my badgering and stuff very politely, so I really appreciate that. But they said that, okay, we're gonna need some time to figure out what's going on here. So I delayed the video to give them a bit more time. But since then, I've not really been able to get any more information out of Gigabyte. I emailed my contact again this morning and I was like, "Hey, it's been 4 business days. Can you at least give me an indication of whether or not Gigabyte considers this behavior to be unusual or not? Is it outside of spec?" And they couldn't do that, which is pretty weird. Like, Gigabyte, you made the product. Surely you should immediately be able to tell if it's behaving abnormally compared to what you intended it to do. Like, what? And that means that, as far as I'm concerned, there are one of two things going on here. Either Gigabyte meant for their version of the 6950 XT to just draw about 290 watts of power while gaming, and this card is working as intended. Which would be pretty stupid, because if you look at benchmarks of like a Sapphire version of the 6950 XT, which draws about 390 watts of power while gaming, it barely outperforms the version that this card replaces, the 6900 XT, which means the 6950 XT is already a pointless product that you're paying an additional $200 for. You don't have any headroom to lose performance due to conservative power draw figures. Like, yeah, so that's the one thing. And then the other option is that there's something wrong with this graphics card and Gigabyte's not been able to figure out what it is yet, which I'm kind of leaning towards that, considering that the tech tester's card, I mean, they showed proper power draw figures for their card. And I really appreciate you sending over your BIOS, because it kind of adds to how weird this whole situation is. Like, why did that different BIOS version not fix the power draw on this card? I don't really know what's going on. But that is about as much information as I have on the topic, so thank you for watching. Let me know in the comment section down below what you think of this whole situation. I will do a follow-up video once Gigabyte figures out what's going on. It'll either be a short or a full video, depending on the scope of the situation, so check out for that. And yeah, until the next video, thank you for watching. Bye-bye.